Triangle Bob, are you trying to grow a garbage tree again? We have been over this, buddy. Planting one Diet Dr. Blocker drink will not give you a whole tree of them. Hmm, that does give me a good idea for a video, though. Cue the intro. Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. Today, we're gonna answer the question that I just made up. Why don't we bury our trash directly into the ground? We did do a video on why we don't just shoot our trash directly into the sun. You can watch that video by clicking the link in the description, but watch this one first. To answer this stinky question, let's take a fun little field trip to the dump. We generate a lot of trash. According to the United States Environmental Protection Agency, in 2018, Americans made 265 metric tons of trash. While much of that is recycled, composted, burned for energy, or managed by other methods, 50% ended up in landfills. It may sound like a landfill is just a big hole in the ground where we throw our trash, but it's actually much more complicated than that, and for a really good reason. You see, rainfall and the trash's natural decomposition process create a toxic liquid called leachate. This contains many pollutants, including heavy metals and ammonia. If this got into the soil, it could harm nearby plants and enter the groundwater, which is a major source of our drinking water. And because a big, buried pile of trash doesn't receive much oxygen from the air, the decomposition process generates methane gas and carbon dioxide. In addition to being a potent greenhouse gas, methane is highly flammable and dangerous if kept sealed beneath the ground. For these reasons, landfills have to be built in a way that keeps these harmful substances under control. This begins by finding a suitable place to build it, away from any environmentally sensitive areas like wetlands. After the hole is dug, a two-part liner consisting of compacted clay topped with a high-density plastic is installed. Next comes a system of pipes to collect and transport the leachate and methane gas to treatment facilities. These systems are continuously monitored to make sure no hazardous chemicals escape. Once full, the landfill is capped with another liner, then topped with soil and plants, and monitored for another 30 years. Of course, landfills aren't a perfect solution. For one, they take up a lot of land. The 3,000 active landfills in the US require 7.3 billion square meters. The liners can also degrade and leak, resulting in a major health risk for anyone that lives nearby. This is why it's important to use other disposal methods like recycling or composting, and to avoid single-use plastics, so that we can decrease the amount of trash and our reliance on landfills. So do you have any more stinky questions for me to answer? Any questions will do, really. They don't have to smell bad. Ask away in the comment section below. Wanna watch more Life Noggin? Click here to watch this video we did on all the times humans almost went extinct. Or click here to watch this video. Subscribe and click the bell so you're notified every time we upload a new video, and click the like button, because it really helps us out. You can also check out the team at Lifespan that powers Life Noggin down in the description. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.